गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई असद पटेल वेलकम यू टू स्टडी फ्रॉम होम। इन अ प्रीवियस क्लासेस आई एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट टेस्ट, टाइप्स ऑफ टेस्ट, फूड, डाइजेशन सिस्टम, ऑर्गन्स ऑफ डाइजेशन सिस्टम एंड प्रॉपर फूड, राइट। इन अ प्रीवियस क्लास आई जस्ट ब्रीफली एक्सप्लेन यू व्हाट इज प्रॉपर फूड। इट इज़ नोन एज अ बैलेंस डाइट विच कंटेंट सम न्यूट्रिएंट्स लाइक फैट, मिनरल्स, कार्बोहाइड्रेट, विटामिन्स, प्रोटीन एंड वाटर, राइट। टुडे आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू मोर अबाउट दिस न्यूट्रिएंट्स, राइट। नाउ लेट मी एक्सप्लेन बैलेंस्ड डाइट। व्हाट इज बैलेंस्ड डाइट? अ बैलेंस्ड डाइट इज अ डाइट दैट कंटेन डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ फूड्स इन अ सर्टेन क्वांटिटीज एंड proportion so that the requirements for a calories, protein, minerals, vitamins and alternative nutrients is adequate and small provisions is reserved for additional nutrients to endure the short length of leanness. Adequate means equal, right? Now let me explain you six major nutrients, that is those are water, protein, carbohydrate, fat, vitamins and minerals. You can read about the functions of these six major nutrients, right? Student, here I am going to explain this chart, means where you will get carbohydrate, where you will get protein and well you will get fat. So these are some food item from which you will get carbohydrate, protein and fats, right? Students, I would like to discuss few questions, right? Why do you think Rashmi could not eat only one roti in the whole day? Just because she belongs to a very poor family. Her mother's income is too less to buy a meal for Rashmi. Do you think Kailash would like games and sports? No, he won't like. Why he won't like sports and games? Because he is very inactive. And how he become a inactive? Just because of this junk food. He didn't had any balance or a proper food, right? What do you understand by proper food? As I already explained you in a beginning of this class, why do you think that the food Rashmi and Kailash was not proper? You can bifurcate, you can make a comparison between the food of Rashmi and Kailash, that Rashmi couldn't get even a single roti in a day and Kailash is not, you know, taking, is not eating balanced food, right? So both of them are not consume proper or balanced food. Here there is a activity, talk with your grandparents or elderly people, means you are supposed to talk with your grandparents or elderly people and ask them, are you able to walk long kilometer of a long distance, or are you able to eat junk food? Answer would be no, they cannot walk for a long distance, right? And they cannot consume junk food. Why? First of all, this elderly people suffering from energy, these are the aging issue, right? Because they cannot active like a young people, right? Because they have digestion problem, they cannot eat heavy food, right? They cannot digest eggs, milk, chicken or mutton or any heavy food. That's why their energy level become a down, right? They cannot walk like young people, and by the time they become a weak and weak. That's why aged people means those who cross 65 year age or 70, near above 70, they cannot walk like us or they cannot eat like us, right? Proper food, every child's right. Students, to serve proper food, government started a midday meals in a government school to achieve or to serve proper food to every child, right? You have read about two children. One is Kailash, who does not like homemade food. The another one is Rashmi, who does not even get one proper meal a day. About half the children in our country are like Rashmi. They do not get enough food that they need to grow and develop properly. These children are weak, sickly, often ill, in poor health. But it is the right of every child to get proper food. Means they belong to very poor family, right? Half of the children, right, who suffering from this problem of not getting proper food. Now, student, I would like to explain you about Gomti. This is an example of Gomti. Gomti is a 30 years old. Gomti worked in a field of a rich farmer as a seasonal labor, right? Whenever farmer feel that there is a work in his field, he called Gomti, and then after a work has been done, Gomti has been sent, okay, not given any other work. For all her hard work, she gets paid very little. So little that she cannot even buy enough rice to feed her family. Some months she does not get any work at all, as I told you. Then she had to eat leaves and roots from the jungle. Gomti's children are weak with hunger and always sick. Few years ago, her husband died of hunger. It is not only Gomti, but there are other people who die every day due to lack of food, due to hunger. More rice grows in Kalahandi district. Rice is even sent to other states from here. Many times the rice that keeps lying in the godown gets spoiled. In the same Kalahandi, there are many poor people like Gomti. Why do people die hunger in such places? This is a question. Why do people die in such places? See, India is an agricultural country, right? Even though people are dying of hunger because unequal distribution of food, right? As I told you, there are huge godown which keeps rice, wheat, maize, all the food item. Even then people are dying just because of unequal distribution of food item, right? So student, this is all about our chapter, from testing to digesting, right? This is all for this chapter. Thank you so much.